Keto or vegan, which is healthier? The answer is probably not what you think it is. A brand new study compared the two diets side by side and measured their health benefits. Here's three takeaways. One, people on the vegan diet ate 7 times more carbohydrates, yet they lost fat. Those on keto did not lose significant fat over the first couple weeks. That's not to say you can't lose fat on a low-carb diet. Of course you can. We know that from multiple studies that followed people longer. The point is, it's not the carbs that make you fat. The people on the vegan diet were going to town on carbs, and yet they lost fat faster. Don't get me wrong, you can lose fat by cutting carbs. You can lose fat by cutting any food, any source of calories, carbohydrate, fat, even protein. The point here is to take an objective look at the health benefits of the diets. I have nothing personal against keto or vegan. In fact, I'm gonna roast both diets on this video. I gotta keep myself entertained somehow. In the study, the people eating vegan were satiated faster and ate less calories. In all likelihood, that's why they lost fat. Now, some of you are going, duh, and if so, congrats. But the truth is, this is still a common misunderstanding. I know even highly educated people, some even scientists, who still say, I gotta lose some weight. I should cut carbs, right? When's the last time you heard that? We hear it all the time. They even make parody memes about it. So the mindset shift is to not focus on the nutrients so much, the carbohydrates and the fat and the protein. It's about food quality. Refined carbs make it easier to gain weight because they're more calorically concentrated and have less fiber. So you eat more calories per bite. Complex carbs and natural foods, also known as whole foods, like greens or beans or whole grains like oatmeal, make it easier to maintain or lose weight because they're calorie dilute and fiber rich. So if by cut carbs you mean cut candy, yeah, great move, assuming you replace it with something healthier. But let's be clear that we're cutting candy because it's an artificial product where the nutrients are refined to their simplest form, not because it's carbs. Otherwise, the next natural question is, well, oatmeal has a lot of carbs too. Should I cut that as well? And we all get confused into general carbophobia, even doctors sometimes. And I don't blame people for getting confused. Okay, next takeaway. Because losing fat is not the only thing we want from our diet. Losing excess fat is good, but there are many ways to lose weight. It doesn't mean it's healthy. So, more health benefits. The vegan diet lowered cholesterol, but it raised triglycerides. Low-carb diets, like keto, tend to do the opposite, especially if they're animal-based. You bring down your cholesterol by shifting a bit from animal to plant fats, except for coconut oil, and you bring down your triglycerides by shifting from simpler to more complex carbohydrates. I've made several videos about optimizing blood lipids. At the end of the video, I'll link one that I highly recommend. But if you have any questions, write them down below and I'll try to make more. So again, the key is the type of food, not if it's high fat or low fat. Both are possible and both can be healthy, which is why these diet wars on social media, keto versus vegan, are a distraction. Vegans and low carbers have been fighting for years. So of course, when this study came out, pitting the two diets face to face, it was like throwing gasoline on fire. Actually, the researchers wanted to keep the study secret, but the vegans wouldn't stop telling everybody about their diet. Now, the people on keto, they didn't tell anybody. They were much better about it. They were too busy asking the vegans, where do you get your protein? Told you I was gonna go after everybody. Seriously, these diet wars miss the big picture. Of course, we're talking about health here. If you're vegan for the animals or the environment, that's fine. But health-wise, a vegan diet can be great or it can be terrible. Candy and cola is vegan. Same goes for keto. It can be healthy, lots of greens, high in fiber, or it can be unhealthy, with processed meats, low fiber, and high saturated fat. So the whole keto versus vegan war is social media smoke. Ironically, while the vegan and keto gurus are worried about winning this battle, the only one winning is the processed food industry, raking in billions. Here's the main reason this comparison doesn't make sense. The two aren't even mutually exclusive. Vegan keto diets are popular and have even been tested in scientific studies, with very good results. You know what they should call it? Keegan, or veto, trademarked. So, to ask which is better, keto or vegan, it doesn't make any sense. Having an abundance and variety of unprocessed plants, that's the golden rule. A healthy diet can be keto or not, vegan or not, low carb or not, high fat, low fat, intermediate fat, many possibilities. Choose the one that works for you and ignore the social media noise. The people on the vegan diet reported increased bowel movement frequency. The people on keto said, what's a bowel movement? The vegans lost 3 pounds of weight in the first week. Pretty good. Even more impressive, they gained 2 inches of height. According to the researchers, it was mainly a result of getting on their soapbox. That's so lame. Leave that one out. The study also looked at demographics. All right. All right. This is so cheesy. The study also looked at demographics. 65% of vegans reported being atheists. Among the keto group, 85% said they don't believe in God, but carbs are definitely the devil. I got this. Let's go. I can do it. Okay. All right. Whoo! If you want to know more about cholesterol and diet, I recommend this video over here. For more on weight loss, try that one.